cool, isn't it? Oh my gosh, this game is so incredible. You know what? I'm actually gonna friend him without any ice.
Yeah, I don't know. You're just standing there.
Because I was trying to bait the trap because ice run out. Now one with the Ronnie. Ronnie and Jeannie.
Oh my god.
If I don't make this, I'm seriously gonna clap.
Oh my god, my mate's in this place.
What's his name?
Popula. Hey, wanna check his left in?
If I don't make this another time, I'm seriously gonna clap.
I'm just gonna go now.
Have you done this already, Ron? Are you on level 2?
Yeah, he's actually an operator.
Yeah, I know, Theo, you told us already, my dudes.
How are you meant to do this?
If I don't make it, I'm gonna clap in a minute.
Why you do every time Jack goes into me? How are you meant to get past
them? Move, Ron! You just stood there baiting the trap while I nearly died.
Oh. I just baited the trap. Oh my god, two of my mates are in this. Two fawns, my mates. And then what you do after a laugh?
What was that laugh?
You want to go do one? Ronnie, I'm gonna go do your death run. Can we go do your death run, Ron? Run.
Yeah.
Can we go do your death run? Okay, that's fine.
Are you going on my death run though?
Yeah, I want to and do it.
I'll complete this level. I want to get to the next level.
You're gonna, yeah, it's quite difficult. You have to go round in a ring and look in the middle, but usually PC servers can really go around.
I'm going on my death run.
See ya!
See ya!
You know, Tough Fan is in the game, by the way, so you might wanna.
Tough Fan.
Is he really? Oh, you know, I'm actually gonna try and complete this level because, Ron, you make your level super difficult now.
You must have made it tough. But I like one of the. I think I'm starting the game.
What? Alright, Ron, yeah, I'm actually gonna have to spawn out of this. Mum, do you want to show you Ron's death run? I know. Where's Joel's on?
These two have got phones. Come back to creative club, two people have got burns.
Are you going back to creative club?
It must have trapped me in.
Are you going to play the death? Yeah, me and Ron are going to do the death run, aren't we, Ron?
Yeah. Guys, come back to creative club for 1 second. There's two hackers.
No.
We've modded the game, guys. Guys, two people have hacked. Come back to creative club.
Got one. Cool.
Guys, come back to creative hub. Look, quick.
back to creator mode?
No, because we don't want him.
Well, you've missed the whole thing, Greg.
Do you like what I've done wrong with the bounce pad? Where's the first land? So, Ron, come here. Alright, I like
what I've... Oh my god, this is so mad the way you... Guys, you've just glitched this so bad. But it's funny. Oh my god. Jack, you need to come back for 1 second.
No.
The game now.
No, not yet. I need to build levels, Ron. Are you building levels?
Do you want to build levels? I don't mind. Do you want to play it?
Yeah, I want to build the levels. I might need your help. I will. Now I get to watch a bit of videos.
I'll tell you what, because these guys are in, I'm going to just start the game. I know,
okay, then start the game. Wait, no, yeah, we started it. Alright, let's go! Let's go! Let's go!
15 minutes.
Let's go!
Stop it, I'm taking you off now.
Why is it I landed on a spawn point up here, alright? Ron, actually, can we go? Theo, are you in Creative Hub?
I'm in the game with the deck.
I know you are, Ron. I'm coming. Worry, don't worry, babe, anymore. Please no. Please no.
Just pack it in now.
I'm sorry. Is it the dropper? I did it 92. Are you done, Ron?
What do you mean?
I mean, you on level 2?
On level 3.
There's a lifted level 3, where you have to do it with like the 90 degrees angle. You have to. Okay. Let's go. So now I'm on level 2, Ron. That was good for me personally. Alright, now this one, how would you do this? How did you, are you turning 90 degrees, Ron? Can you come back and show me how you do it? How do you do the third one, though, Ron? Pardon?
Oh, easy joystick forward and back. Like, move, like, sprint forward.
Yeah.
And sprint forward, turn around.
Hi. Right. We need to make a death run 3.0 when we've done this one.
amazing that I can't do it. I'm KIA. KIA is like, I know, Mum. You don't have to keep reminding me. I said you don't have to keep reminding me. But I know you don't have to keep reminding me. I know all the time.
Oh, okay. So if you're not off this bike, you're not keeping an eye on the time, you're not off bike. Bike off 7 minutes in place, man. So, I will.
Ah, can we make levels run?
Make levels. I just don't know about if there's any other people in the, you know.
Well, no, because we look, they're getting SMG'd, aren't they? Look in the chat.
Make levels.
Yeah. End this game, dude. Alright, so Ryan, if you come here.
Yeah.
You're right there, alright, you're in the death row, okay. So I mean, this part right now. Hide in. Hide in. I'm gonna do a lot of reading after. I don't like it that you're forcing me. Right, so I'm gonna pull. Run.
Yeah.
I think I'm on like level 12 of this death run. Ron, how much levels do you want in your death run?
A lot. Why?
I don't know. Come here, Ron. So come here. Fly up here. So basically, you want. So basically, if you come up here, which you are, yeah. You wanna fly up here, then you wanna hit this, so come down here after that. And you wanna hit this, then you wanna. So basically, watch me. You know, I'm gonna come up here, I'm gonna hit this bounce pad. I'm gonna come up here. And then I'm gonna dodge all the traps because all the ice has been gone, yeah. Then you want to go down there. Then you want to keep on coming. And this is where I'm building all the walls and stuff. So they basically, I think where I'm on like level 12 already. Yeah. You want a 38.
I'm fine with that gap. I don't really want it.
You don't want it in?
No, sorry.
Okay. So what level, what else level should we build? Because we've got the bit where we're going up to here, and then you like the bit, you like the bit here. So what should we do after this here?
One sec, I can't. What just happened? I'm thinking let's just put it simple. Let's make a maze.
A maze, okay. So for level 12, we're gonna make a maze.
For whatever the next level is. What I've been doing so far. For level, wait. That's the next level.
Oh yeah, I've already got it, look.
And then jump up here.
I'm making this maze already.
I don't really want a bouncer, I think it would just be better with the board. But I want to put traps in there to make it look like, oh, I'm going down. Do you think this is a good death run or not?
I think it's a really good death run, do you?
I'd have done better.
I think it's good. I don't think that it's like really bad or anything, Rod. So now when it comes to the maze, jump. Remember?
I just had a brilliant idea for the next level.
Yeah, so the maze, yeah, we're onto the maze now, so if you come up here, run. Follow me, you know, see me, yeah. So basically, as you can tell, I've built all these, like, are you nearly, yeah, so if you come up here, I've built all these big platforms and stuff. And then I've done, this is where the maze is gonna start, really. Walls down the maze. Drunk? Okay, nothing's wrong. I don't know why you're smiling. No, I just said I don't know why you're smiling.
I'm not
saying that, it just looks like a different smile. Right. As you can tell, this pit's up here.
Maybe this could be my, what's it called, level? Hoverboard level.
Oh yeah, it could be instead of the maze. Then it come up here, well, and then you get, and then you're gonna, yeah, so you're gonna hit the launch pad, and you're gonna land in here, and then it's gonna be like a hoverboard level, so I'll place out spawns. You get on, Ronnie, you can get on with like the building where you want to do like the parkour, and I'll get on with them.
No! Unfortunately, I think I know where, which way I want to do it. Like, I think we should, Jack.
Yeah.
We should work from the top and slowly make our way down so that it curves in, comes through here.
Okay.
Goes back out of, like, so it curves back in and then out again.
We need to have water. We need to just get floors because, like, whenever you take the hoverboard spawn pad out, right? Yeah. So I'll get up top. And now I.
I'm gonna what? Be evil. I wanna make another trap tunnel, even though, actually, no. What items are there and what is good to use?
What's wrong?
Nothing, Jack.
I don't know what he's. You've been well born. Oh, did you see that? Run. Right, what do you think? What do you mean you clock? I know you're clocking the time, what's so bad about that? What's wrong?
You know what's gonna happen. You've been well born.
What's gonna happen? What's gonna happen?
You know what's gonna happen. You go 1 minute over 7 minutes off it tomorrow.
Okay. 2 minutes. Alright, run.
Whoa.
I'm trying
to. Drop me on my toffee.
Drop me. I will run. Beep. Bop. Billy. Alright. I'm back now, so where are we start? All right, so you mean you wanna not
Alright.
Oh, I want to try and play the death run.
Go to the scissors death run then, Ren.
Can we do scissors death run together?
Yeah, sure. We can do it together.
Scissors is fun.
I know, but very rage inducing at the same time. It is not letting me leave the island. It's not letting me leave.
Break stuff in the island.
Is it letting you leave your island? Because it's not for me.
I'm in the bottom, I'm glitched. Whoa. Major. Are you out or?
No, are you?
Yes.
It's not letting me. Every time I press back to Creative Hub. Let me back to Creative Hub. What? I'm sorry?
Get off.
How? Why? I have to go anyway now, Ron. Bye.
Can you mention the plate on that unit now, please? No.
What do you read to you?
You sit there and you read, put your phone away.
Wait, do you want me to read to you?
If you want, pass me the remote, please.
Why? You don't have to read.
Yeah, you do.
You're forcing me.
Yeah, I am.
You want the prize? Do you want me to get the prize?
You don't read, lads.
I'm saying, do you want me to get the prize? Do you want me to get the prize?
Do not even attempt to put this telly, put any PS
on this
couch.
Do you want me to get the prize? Is that why you're making me read?
No, you're not going on. Don't even attempt. Till after you have read for 2 hours tomorrow.
I'm reading 2 hours tomorrow.
Yeah, you are.
Why?
Because
I've done nothing for you to tell
you
me
know
to
that
read.
Game order.
Yeah, but more, I've done nothing for you to tell me to read for 2 hours tomorrow. I'm not gonna sit there and read for 2 hours.
You're not playing the game.
Well, I can take 2 hours off my time on my game.
So, lad, you're not on the game now.
No, what? I don't want to sit there for 2 hours and read a book, Mum. Just say, I don't
care. You're not playing the game?
Fine, then I'll read 2 hours of a book tomorrow and you make me sit there and get myself hyper because you want me to sit there for 2 hours straight.
And you're going to read now? But the game's banned.
Yeah, you want me to read for 2 hours and 2 hours tomorrow? Oh, wow, that's tons for me.
Phone away.
You want me to read for 6 hours but then 6 hours in total for Tuesday? You want me to read like 4 hours Tuesday?
Do not get any more chocolate. Do not get any more chocolate. No, you've had enough jellies. You've had two jellies today. You've had one this morning, one at lunchtime. You had one this morning. Get here now. Get here now. You had a jelly this morning, sitting at the table with me because you put cream on it. You did.
I only had one this afternoon.
You're not having a jelly. I've just warned you. You'd answer me back again. You're in bed till tomorrow.
I don't want to go my phone.
You're not. You're getting your book. You're reading. Answer me back. You're in bed.
Okay, I want to understand though. Why you are personally forcing me to read when it's the weekend? I've never read.
Banned them. Tomorrow.
No, Mum, no. I asked you why are you...
Banned.
No, no, please, I've asked...
Because you only play on a game when everything is done.
What?
You've stayed on that game 5 more
because
minutes,
you
five
let
more
me.
Minutes, 5 more minutes,
I,
5 more minutes.
You let
yeah.
me?
And now you're creating. Warned you, lad. Game will go.
I'm not creating over the game. I'm creating because you were telling me to read.
You're meant
me.
To read.
But why don't you want me to get the prize? That's what you told me to read.
Well, yeah, and because you know what? You should be reading. So until you've done what I ask you to do, do not even attempt to mention the game. You mentioned the game, the PS4 is disconnected.
I'm
going to
read 10 pages.
You won't read 10 pages.
Well, how long do you want me to read them 6 hours?
You'll sit there and you'll read until I tell you to stop.
How long will that be? 2 hours?
Move.
I'm saying how long will that be?
As long as it takes me.
I'm saying how long will it take?
As long as it takes.
Okay, I've won.
You'll read for a whole hour.
I've won.
You'll read for an hour.
A whole hour. That's well too long for me. You play to sit still on the rug for a whole hour.
What
am I doing? Oh, why? I could just sit still for 45 minutes.
You've just sat there for hours and hours playing the game.
I was actually wriggling and clapping like that because I was annoyed.
You sat there for hours playing the game.
Do you want your game to go?
Carry on.
I never said I want it to go.
You'll get your game.
But I don't. Well, maybe it needs like 45 minutes.
Go to bed.
No. I don't want to read for a whole hour. Not if I don't read.
Get the book 5, 4, 3.
I'm going to go get my book. You just said go get your book, so I'm going to go get it.
9 minutes, finish tomorrow. Talk to me with respect. Tell what you're going to
okay,
do.
Speak to me calmly.
I'm perfectly calm. You've been
okay,
well
fine. I'm going to read to you, but I want to ask you something first. I'm speaking calmly.
You're not speaking calmly, you're sitting proud.
Well, I'm going to speak calmly now, as we always when I'm calm. Can you give me the explanation, please? Why you want me to read? Is it because you want me to get the prize?
Well, because you should be reading. You were given a challenge to do, and that was really good for the end. You had a deal that
it
you could only
try.
Be quiet. Be quiet and talk. That game came secondary to you reading. But you spent all day on that game, so you ruined it for yourself.
I'm gonna read now?
Yeah, we'll be quiet.
How long would you make me read if I didn't go on that game?
You've been reading, you were told that you were reading for the evening.
You expect me to read
until
12 o'clock or something?
Yeah, I do.
Whoa, you expect me to...
Do you know if you're answering me back? I'm warning you now. I'm about ready to
three
get
hours.
Up. Disconnect that PS4 and phone your brother to come get it.
You want me to read for 3 hours?
You'll carry on reading until I tell you.
And I'm saying how long will that be?
An hour. Move.
Oh, bye, but I'm not reading to you. I'm going to feed in my head.
Get in your bed.
I'm reading so you told me to.
Cry one more time, you're in bed till tomorrow.
I'm crying though. And that's what I'm doing no more.
I've just well warned you what will happen.
I don't even know what I'm up to, so how am I gonna read? I'm gonna read then, I'll read.
One more word, lad. You'll be put to bed and that'll go. It would be there.
I don't know where I'm up to.
Well, try and
You got extended your beam, I don't know where I'm up to. Jacob's for a bit. She whipped Vermont tells the dirty strokes, but it's not a great great Hermes. We give him some sleep. That was the perfect thing. Oh, but the thing is though, yeah, is that I know your dog wasn't on because you wanna know why. I know you don't. I was gonna say, Joel was on last night and then 8 o'clock I didn't accept his friend request till like 9. So he was probably did bring it on this because I'm just trying to cheer me up. Anyway, we've got to make a stop on this way, Green Turnies. We got this again, old mate of yours. Mom, because I like these books a lot.
It's just kind of weird.
Whoa, said Elliot. I've had a breakthrough in my reset. And a theme, excitingly. There's a way you can take the airstone with no fear of punishment. Brilliant, said Elliot. What is it? A royal pardon, said Effie Farley. What is that? Asked Virgo, said, and gets out a bowl of dreaming jelly. I think I'm on a need to think great wind. The Farley get out of jail free card sentence. Quite merrily. Brainy boom is going on all about yesterday, moaned Aphrodite. If you had a royal pardon, you couldn't get in trouble. You just have to go and get it from the Queen, Elliot. We want to see her again. Me did I shift on. Day's last day before the vault closes, said Hermes. I'll saddle up the vault closes. Trying to top hole, said Zeus. Must be on your guard at all times. I'm some jealous power to that bright light. I'd love to meet the Queen. She's such an inspiring figure of an email of female leadership, and her bling is off the scale. We're going to be busy, said the theme, handing Zeus an appetite piece of parchment. These arrived in Hera this morning. There are assessments. You must complete all these tasks before the end of the day. Why the bally heck would I need to carve your backwards while an exciting pamphlet towards Zeus? What? I need to do this in a short voice, because it's got me just going to do exclamation mark there. Why the bally heck would I need to carve your backwards while exciting pamphlets? Roared Zeus, reading the sheet. This is outrageous! Let's just get it done in those zappers off, said Athena. Children, good luck then. We'll be thinking of you. All be perfect, said Virgo. It will return with the airstone tonight. Elliot's hand went to airstone, but with the airstone in his what? How am I pronouncing?
T-H-A-N-A-T-O-S. Phoenicis?
Oh, the silent letter, right?
Phantos
is in his head, and the powers control the elements of Earth in his pocket. I need to get my pillow in my bed so I can... I wish I could come along and talk to you.
Sit up and then just leave.
Can I get my pillow? I mean, I can still go in the team. I'm sure you know that. It's not okay. All again. Can you just put that back to...
Just carry on leaving.
Is he kissing him?
No.
The chariot from a nearby manhole looking to the park itself. There she reflected on the last visit to Buckingham Palace where they had been surprised to discover that she was wearing charming hats. Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II in fact possessed the best of secrets and ninja skills. And then she kicked hypnosis put into the next week with Elliot's EV counted their last meeting terms. Because it's Sunday tomorrow yet, you know if I wake up early then yeah. Do you want me to read a bit to you?
Mm.
What?
No, you just put me through from read, Jack.
Yeah. And if you're still sleeping, like I've woken up, I've woken up in my book, so I just pick it up and you force me.
Yeah. That's what you should do. That's what I did.
No. You either make yourself a cup of tea or go back to sleep, or you grab a book like you do.
Yeah.
You bake because you know what like you used to do, you used to. You couldn't sleep, you used to go to the room when I was asleep and get the baking container and you turn 12 o'clock and go to sleep again. Because you feel like your night is not satisfied until you've read the book. Which, you can actually read a bit now. Look, Hermes began rummaging from his infinite bag. Out came a frog, a tagging, an ornament, a lamp, a stand, and a mouse guard for a riding camel. But despite his fancy grab, Hermes couldn't find the helmet. Matey Ryan, I must have left it in my other bag. I was just determined it was the bosh. It was most suboptimal. The royal pardon was the vital to the success of the quest. Hermes decided she wasn't going to panic. How are we going to get in, she panicked. Not sure, said Elliot, looking around me for inspiration. An American northern lodge had approached the policeman as the gates opened into the car of the palace courtyard. Excuse me, officer, he said loudly. Excuse me, officer, he said loudly. Is this Buckingham Palace? Yes, sir. How may I help you? Get a selfie with the Queen, said my tourist. My mom is just crazy about it. No, it's in fast.
No, but you still slow down.
There, John walked towards the open gate. If they were quick, perhaps they could just... Can I help you, said the policeman, as he read those back down. Yes, please. On a ridiculous accent for reasons that weren't certainly clear. It's these, my hotel. I just arrived in London and I'm... London. It was like, London. And I'm looking for somewhere to stay. And I'm very tired and I want to sleep. Hold on. It says this, reach page 139, well past that. But, you know, it is one of the most funniest pages in the book, so I guess I'll read it to you. Actually, do you want to read this book all over again?
No, just carry on.
Okay, I'm going to read it from 110, though, but like, I'll put the back of the page and all the stuff right here. I am bad, your constellation is really arcane. I was using very covered almost. Clumsy, gears, left Hades. They're going to make your business cards easier, are you sure? I hear the grin of shaking Katie's hand. And clicked his fingers. I'm sure there's a budget in down the road. I said, young man, fell. Hush, in New Town, there's no need to be alarmed. The nearby builder flipped off the Victoria. What is the curious more ritual there, Johnson? London is quite optimal. Young man, signed the construction worker. The place can you can go. And the American mortal, when you were short of your dog, you could stay here, boomed to deep is one of the people had actually wearing some kind of senatorial outfit during them. I'm sure you will find that one. What's that like, said young? A Native American chief smiled earlier. They're with quick enough.
Yeah.
Okay. I need to do it.
Stop that.
No.
You should go down the table.
Ready?
Yeah.
Do you want me to go?
Yeah.
I can't help it.
No, it's becoming a silly habit. And you're going to know about it based on in life because you'll be in agony.
Want me to stop now?
No.
I can't go. It's so hard. I'm clicking your neck if you put it on your, like, your neck. Something every day when you try to click it, it'll give you like a lucky shot. Which not existent.
No, it isn't.
Alright, have a good meal. What was that there? Do you want to use the quick your neck?
No.
Well, they used to, didn't
you? Mm-hmm. Always in agony for this one.
It's tourist information, so we're still in the boat. If I stop now, I'm still in it, even in the boat.
No. Be on me.
So that's super late. It's nice and it hurt, and then you stop super late. So that's why it hurt. Oh. Elliot Bear, chapter 22, a right royal barbecue. Elliot Bear and Hermes stuck around the outside of the palace until they were in the gardens. Immaculate flower beds punctuated their beautiful manicured walls, which spread like a velvet green carpet as the sun started to descend from the sky. This is optimal, Mother Bed, approvingly. I don't want to draw attention to our. The sound of the. You know what? I'm actually going to imagine for my neck here that this is going to give me a lucky shock if I click it. So that way, at least I have it in my head's dream. Did you get in yet? I'm supposed to get thinking how many bullets raiders. Let's see if I did this. No, I'm saying if I'd step like this. Not like this. Ah! It can be a lot of shot. No, ma'am, said I like quickly. But this is Hermes. He's the best one. No, ma'am, said Hermes with the green fluttering up and bowing the dead. It's an honor to meet you, Royal Paladins. The Paladins said to be with the warm smell. We're just having a barbecue supper. Would you care to join us? Oh, yeah. You have nothing in the stomach but tasted jammy dodges. Marvellous for the food. Come and meet the family. She led the way to a sheltered plateau area where the other men were sitting in the barbecue beneath the row of their lamps. Everybody, this is Mr. Elliot Uber about who prepared so much for the food. Hello there, Prince Harry and Prince Philip made the cheeseburgers. What should we do? Clever burgers and the Prince of Wales, the Duchess of Cornwall, and the barbecue.
Slow down.
Sorry. Do you bring any demons with you this time, Joe Prince William with the Duchess of Cambridge and Prince George?
Cambridge.
Cambridge and Prince George. Prince George. Not today, Green Dahlia. Glad you found us all right, said the Queen, pouring another slice of progressed cheese on your burger.
Processed.
This can be quite frightful and tricky to get in and out. It's a nightmare when one of these wishes to snip for a kebab. Health for kebab. Tell me, Liz. One icon to another. How did you stay in such fanging shape with it? Asked Hermes. Well, the cordials do keep you on my toes, said the Queen, patting Hermes' hair. Tell them all about sex and change you for hours every day, asked Virgo. You say that to the Queen, because apparently she looks fat, but really she's saying she looks fit. Hermes looked up into the sky, evening sky, evening sky, where a large black cloud now hovered reliable men Your British weather is even less reliable than your buses, said Bad Tyler. They watched the car began to descend, blackening the air. Elliot suddenly had a very, very bad feeling. Children, said the Queen, sorry.
Slow down.
Sorry. While the clouds unfolded upon the black wings, we'll be on that door. I think we have another one to the guest. Nink, said Hermes, with the black cloud transformed into a phone, which is being lost, that's swimming down to water. What the? So you're having a party? You're having a party? A party? Screeched Minks, leaving the rocks that were clutched in their talons. Mind if I join you? Here's my contribution. Contribution. The party scattered like rocks on a window pane as Minks pelted them with the huge rocks. Did he smash them with rocks? So he killed the Queen with a rock man.
Just read the pictures.
Just pelted me. Taking a hit to the head. Hermes cried, Virgo is the messenger to God's God for the days to lift the ground. Is everyone alright? Asked the Queen from behind the barbecue room. I'm fine, shut up and turn around the silver ball. I don't know. But the wretched creature will just come on. Look how she's coming around again. Now the Prince of Wales diving into a nearby fountain. Mink swooped back into the sky with a green flat smoke spinning around to throw in the next patch of missiles. The night Hermes mumbled groggily after I found Toss's mum, who literally the mother of them washed Elliot's heart race given out of goodness, so he decided to stand out. She didn't dare hit her to prevent Toss's and hit Nurse's mother. The messenger of the gods slumped to the ground with conscience. Elliot, child, there's a John! The pair leapt from their midnight in place just with his huge boulder landed with their broken bodies. Would have been if they remained with the Any giant rock smashed a nearby crystal ball, splattering the Queen with potato salad. How dare you, shouted their majesty, looking me in the face out of their eyes and the The terrifying disapproving glare, the Queen metamorphosed her scarf around their forehead like a commander of war machine when all their aiming. Oh, the Queen has a gun. Look. How dare you, shouted her, listen. How dare you, shouted her majesty, waving mayonnaise out of her eyes with a large hanky with a terrifying, disapproving glare. The Queen retired her scarf around their forehead, looking commanding to the machine without her apron pocket. Right, that's it. One is frightfully sorry, mate, but you have not been granted an audience. Family, let's kick some bottom. The Queen grabbed some corn on the cob and loaded it in her gun as an ammunition. She fired. Pieces of corn whistled through the air, and a barrage of tiny bullets and nothing to stop her swooping down on the gathering again. Run into the bigger, harder, more deadly, said the Queen. Camellia, where are the roses? What?
Camellia.
Camellia, already on a chance of the Duchess of Cornwall yanking the statue out of the ground and its personals, revealing the garden ornament, but was in fact a huge bazooka to keep off the statue's antagonist. Tweet. Yes! Can I
go? No, you have enough eggs, but the last one too many eggs. Too many eggs is not good for you.
I want to have one of the eggs.
You're not having an egg?
No, but I want to have one of the
okay, what do
you two want? Because I'm hungry, but you're going to do something completely different.
Yeah, I'll make you something else, but you're not having an egg.
I've had one egg this week.
You had two eggs poached yesterday.
That was
fun. Yeah, you got two. Don't argue with me again. And then the day before you had eggs. You're not having eggs again. Too many eggs isn't good for you, Jack.
The queen. It's always a menace. It's not a mythological monster. It's just trying to prime minister. Your Majesty. Like Majesty. To anyone. You too, Mr.
No, just warned you.
I mean, I'm not going to.
Yes! Don't do that. Yeah.
240, please. What? Don't stop. What? Stop. Right, you're getting soup.
No.
Yeah.
Soup?
Yeah.
Toast, please.
Before, you go in there to eat your tea, scrub those hands.
No.
You just need washing, Jack.
For what?
I'm going to put some hot water in
the table. Now what have I done? I don't need to wash my hands.
I can't hear you. What?
Don't move your robot down.
Thank you. Thank you. I Thank you.
And it's considered dangerous and young people have to wear helmets and stuff.
gotta do what I gotta do.
Battle.
So just leave it on the floor for now.
Get my phone.
Little meanie. Not to watch the floor. No. Take me easy. That's your charge. Charge it now. But don't move the charger.
What the choice is for us sometimes. So don't get a little scared. I've
Let's go, baby! Let's go, dude!
Mm-hmm. What? Are you giving it to me? Where's the phone?
What?
Give me the phone.
My phone.
This show
doesn't waste
any
money.
No, she knows about it, please, until I'm finished. Move the phone.
What's it the exact scene?
Come on, the meat is running!
Well, yours is projectile cover, isn't it? I know, I'm saying yours is the projectile cover, isn't it? Pardon?
As long as Wi-Fi is on, that's all that matters.
Well, do I need to turn my body around?
You don't, it doesn't matter.
Okay, you shouldn't have learned
to
turn it on then. Can I turn it on then?
But Wi-Fi on doesn't matter.
No, it is not working!
But it's just not for me.
Look, retry. No connection. What is it? I need to turn my body around.
Hurry up, half an hour.
Yeah.
Lads, do that to me again, you're in bed, and you'll stay in your room tomorrow.
You have arrived at your destination.
Thank you.
Thank you. Right now, one of the fighters starting to make his way through this crowd and toward the ring. Thank you. Oh my god! Thank you. Thank you. thought that we were in danger. So I shouted to my husband, you have to come to higher ground. I saw electric wires being cut and falling down. It was scary, and I shouted that everyone needed to come higher.
I was running with the camera and looking back, running backwards and filming while I evacuated. I was heading to the emergency staircase at the school. It was right near the river, and I went and looked over, and I could see the water rising up over the bank. I thought I might be in trouble here when the wave came over the levee. Still, I wasn't too worried because I thought it was only a little bit of water. But I was wrong. Since quite a lot of water suddenly gushed over. I thought this is pretty bad. But there's nothing I could do about it. I was amazed and scared by the force of nature. I was on my bike. And I was heading towards a nearby high school. You weren't just running, you were running for your life. Just as it spilled over, I began climbing the staircase. I kept climbing while filming behind me. It happened so quickly. If I'd gone any slower, I don't think I would have made it. There was too much water, and I couldn't get to the school building. So I just climbed up a tree. Watching from the school, you can see our homes in the distance, disappearing under the waves. As it rose higher, you could see people who weren't able to escape. You could see cars just get completely swallowed up by the waves. We were really afraid that the school would get washed away.
すごく言ってました。
just shocked, speechless. It felt like the end. We had lost everything.
I was not expecting that nature could be this dreadful and that it could change so much. Normally, even the sea can get rough sometimes, like during storms, but we never had such damage, houses being destroyed. We could not do anything this time. All we could do was watch what was happening. It was so horrible. I don't know what to say.
Everyone was looking in the direction of the helipad, screaming. For a second, I had forgotten that I had my camera with me, but I quickly remembered. Was it dusk? I used the zoom function to see what people were looking at and saw waves of water. I knew straight away. I saw piles of cars being swallowed by the muddy water. Very quickly. It happened really fast. To be honest, I didn't expect the water to come all the way to where I was. There were many buildings between where the cars were and me, so I thought it would stop. It had never occurred to me that the tsunami would reach us. It looked surreal. It was like watching a film. I honestly couldn't believe it. It was a big road in the middle of town. You would never have realized it was actually a coastal area. You could say I was naive, but even just before it hit, there were police out directing traffic. I could see the tsunami coming towards those cars stuck in traffic. I was really worried about it, but there was nothing I could do. Some people were screaming as loud as they could to warn the people in the cars down below, but they couldn't have heard them when I think about it now. The first time I realized a tsunami was going to hit was when I actually saw it myself. I looked in my rearview mirror and saw an even larger wave than the one in front of me. I didn't know what to do. People were running out of their cars. I suppose that's about it. I think everyone was really panicking. It was incredibly quick. It probably took only 10 or 20 seconds from the moment when the water hit my car to the car being washed out.
進み出してるんでしょ。
I was quite calm. I thought that's how things go, so I might as well do as much as I can. I decided just to sit inside and wait. I figured that even if my cargo swept up by the tsunami, it might land in some place, and I might be able to float to safety.
I saw many cars being swallowed by the water and swept away. There wasn't anything we could do. We even talked amongst ourselves if there was a way to help, but nothing could be done.
Mind that I'd use the car to protect me as long as possible. The car would float somewhere safe. Or, if that was impossible, when the opportunity came, I'd jump out and float to safety. I figured I'd have to swim for it. Which way was up. It was probably just a minute, but I swam around there in the water, and I thought I was going to die. Finally, my face hit the surface, and I could breathe.
Strikes, you can always rely on Mini Baby Bell to save the day. This Red Nose Day, 5p from every pack goes to Comic Relief. Take Super Fast Fiber and choose another bit of smart kit worth up to 179 pounds. Like an Amazon Echo, Fitbit Charge 3, or a Samsung Galaxy Tablet. Get Super Fast Fiber Essential for $29.99 a month on an 18-month contract. Make more of your broadband and have some tech on us. Join by 14th of March. Search PT Broadband or call 0800 080 060. Be there.
Now I need the right domain name for my label. Miss Taylor.
Actimel contains yogurt and L-calcite live cultures. It also contains vitamins D and B6 that help support the normal function of the immune system. So you feel ready to take on the day. Show us your winter bottle attitude. Actimel.
Amazon Prime gets you fast, unlimited delivery on millions of things like rugs. But you can also use Prime to watch Tom Clancy's Rugged, Jack Ryan, and thousands of other shows included in your Prime membership. All for only $7.99 a month.
I didn't start more than for pie charts and golf days. I took help, Pete. Lady Luck won't respect your plans. Lose power now, and your little monkeys will run riot. So be prepared to nip the can of worms in the bud, get it fixed, secure with us, and get 24-hour emergency call now. You call, we listen, we act. More than we do more.
Start a journey into your family's past with Ancestry DNA and discover your ancestors' origins. Order your kit today at ancestrydna.co.uk. My name is Liv. I'm a virtual ambassador for Reno Qajar, created to experience real emotions, to feel strong, powerful. While everyone is trying to live in the virtual world, I'm making it in the real one. You should try it. Get into the real world with new Reno Qajar for only £199 a month.
Careful with my phone, Jack.
Every copy needs a loader.
Expedia, you can book your flight, hotel, car hire, and activities all in one place. No need to go. Expedia, Atoll Protected. Hi.
Hi. What turns you on?
Celebrating International Women's Day, the network premiere of The Love Witch, tonight at 11:30.
Robin Williams frocks up as Mrs. Doubtfire in the 90s family classic, tomorrow at 6:35 here on Film 4. French Affairs for Gemma Arterton at 9 o'clock in the premiere of Gemma Bovary. And then at 11:05, a very unconventional office romance for Maggie Gyllenhaal and James Spader in Secretary. Spiders now, on the other hand, though. We're continuing our International Women's Day celebration all weekend, starting right now with a supernatural spectacular of a premiere. Melissa McCarthy, Kristen Wiig, Kate McKinnon, and Leslie Jones are the conductors of the metaphysical examination. Or the Ghostbusters, if you prefer.
The 9 p.m. bell, proudly sponsored by NAFTA.
The Aldrich Mansion is the only 19th century home in New York to preserve both inside and out.
At the time of its construction, it was one of the most elegant homes in existence. Interesting fact, this grandfather clock was on the Titanic and was saved by Sir Aldrich. A Romanian woman and her child were forced to leave the lifeboat to make room. Over here, you can imagine Sir Aldrich entertaining his wealthy guests. It's said that in this very room, P.T. Barnum first had the idea to play ballet. Follow me. Now, I'm going to tell you something a little spooky. The morning of October 25th, 1894, Sir Aldrich awoke, furious, when his breakfast was not waiting for him. So he called to his servants, but none of them responded. Why? Because during the night, one by one, they had each been stabbed to death in their sleep. It was later discovered they were murdered by his eldest daughter, Gertrude Aldrich. Sir Aldrich once wrote in his diary, "I know God makes no mistakes, but I believe he may have been drunk when he built Gertrude's personality." Now, to spare the family public humiliation, instead of turning her into the police, they locked her in this basement, and they fed her through this slot. Years later, when a new owner moved in, they dug out her remains. But after repeatedly hearing strange sounds, he sealed it shut. That's right, no one has opened this door since then. Okay, follow me. Maybe steer clear of the door.
Caught up, you know, in those dumb awards.
Awards are massively important.
Yes, no, I was saying it'd be dumb not to go after a war.
That's unfortunately the only way to draw attention to good science. Excellent point. All right, we should be going.
Hey, Simon.
Well, I'm going to lecture right now in the big hall. It's good that it's big, too, because I got a lot of big ideas I'm going to be spreading.
Hey, good luck on your tenure review. Make me proud.
Fingers crossed. Not that crossing your fingers means anything.
Oh, I really disagree more.
It's been proven that superstitions can have tremendous performance benefits. Exactly. I'm wrong about everything. Okay, well, I'm going to try to get out of here without stepping on these cracks. My mom calling me like, ah! Oh, see, when they change direction, you gotta,
So you know her.
Oh, I know.
Yeah.
Sean, that is an excellent question. As you can see from my calculations, we will soon be able to combine general relativity and quantum theory. Teaching in the big hall, big day. Oh, man. Big hall.
Sorry to interrupt, but I need to speak to you about something you wrote.
Sorry, yes, what publication?
I'm talking about your book.
Sorry, I don't know what you mean. If you'll excuse me, my class will be here any minute.
You're Aaron Gilbert, right? Co-author of Ghosts from Our Past, both literally and figuratively. The study of the paranormal?
I think you are looking for a different Aaron Gilbert. One that likes very long titles.
Okay, but this really does look like you.
What? No. Look, it was a very long time ago, and it was just a gag between a couple of friends. Sorry.
A 460-page gag? The first sentence is, this is not a joke?
What do you want?
Well, I'm Ed Milgrave. I'm the historian of the Eldridge Mansion. And I believe it's haunted. If you could just come take a look. I tried the police, but I just sound crazy.
I'm sorry. That book you're holding is utter nonsense. I don't even know how you got that. I thought it was
already... It's on Amazon, both hard copy and ebook.
What?
It's on books on tape, too. Only I know how to read.
Is it now? No! Oh, I'm gonna kill you, Annie. Oh, hi! Oh, Dr. Fillmore. Hello, hi.
You're set for the final review of your tenure case on Thursday.
Great.
But I saw that you had a recommendation letter from Dr. Brenham at Princeton. Their science department is really not what it used to be. And I would consider getting a referral from a more prestigious college.
More prestigious than Princeton?
Yes. You see, I think you're an asset to modern physics. But I would hate to see you throw it down the drain.
No, sir, I won't throw it down the drain. And I will get on that letter. Yes, Princeton. More like Prince. Tons of dummies go there.
About your clothes.
Yes. Too sexy for academia.
Never mind.
No, what is it?
Never mind.
Abigail continues her passion for the study of the paranormal at the Kenneth P. Higgins Institute. Lunch, and I've been waiting an hour.
You know they make smaller headphones now, right?
It's an advance in science. Thank you for asking. Probably the future you're looking at. Here you go. Why don't you show Miss Gilbert to the door?
Oh, it's just the same door we came in from.
Yeah, no, I know.
It's really not that hard.
No, don't.
Try it.
Poorly.
You put our book online without my permission.
I don't need your permission.
Of course you need my permission. I wrote that book with you. My name is on it.
No, absolutely not. That book is a whole new revenue stream for me, and I'm like one-tenth away from getting a new mini fridge in here.
Look, I am up for tenure right now.
Ooh, I'm up for tenure.
And if my colleagues at Columbia University Google my name, that is the first thing that comes up, along with a ghost emoji now. Thank you very much. That does a little damage.
You know what? That book was our baby, and you abandoned that baby before it even learned to fly.
Okay, well, books can't fly.
Okay, darling.
And neither can babies.
You don't know, but I'll tell you what, if I had a human baby that could fly, I wouldn't be telling the press about it. If I had a flying baby, I'd zip this, so would you.
There is no experimental backing for anything in that book, and it makes me look like a crazy person.
God, are you kidding me? What? I got one wonton. I got a tub of soup, and I got one split wonton. Look at that, just floating there.
I'm sorry you're having a soup crisis right now.
There's not even any meat in there. That's just a carrot.
Abby, please.
Yes. Abby, I have one wonton. What do I have to do? I'll take my top off for Betty if it gets me three more wontons. I swear to God.
You carry a lot of tension in your shoulders. Sorry, hello? Who are you? Hold on. Virgo, avid skier, gluten full, and 100% jazz to meet you.
Well, don't get too close to her, Holtzman. She'll end up right up on me. Watching green.
Okay.
She works with me here in the lab. She's a brilliant engineer and very loyal. She would not abandon you.
I get it.
She also happens to specialize in experimental particle physics.
Oh.
She was almost hired by CERN.
Very impressive. Oh, what happened?
There was a lab incident. But he's gonna wake up.
He woke up yesterday.
Great.
Then he screamed and went back into a coma.
Well, I bet all that screaming tuckered him out.
Please.
Oh, gosh. It sounds like a great time, but I'm going to have to say no, because Holtzman and I are really busy here actualizing what we just theorized about in our book.
Really?
Yeah. We're incredibly close on the hollow laser for the reverse tractor beam. Really close.
You're making a reverse tractor beam? Abby, why don't you let her listen to the EVP?
What
EVP?
No, not, there's no EVP.
It's electro voice phenomenon. I'm familiar. I know what it means.
It's never been
substantiated.
Oh, there hasn't? There hasn't been one. You know what? You come with this suit on. You get so cocky.
A few months ago, we spent 8 nights at the Chelsea Hotel. We didn't get anything.
Well, we didn't think so. And later, in the lab, when we were reviewing these tapes,
got me.
You know what? Usually we can't even get people over here, but we have never.
She came right home.
Never had anybody actually put their face down close to the machine.
It's a cool joke. It was funny. Disgusting. Is it more or less disgusting if I tell you it came from the front?
Cute.
I can do it live if you want.
Oh.
What's next? You gonna give me a wedgie?
No, I think both of us pretty much feel you have enough stuck up your butt.
Bye! Okay, you know what? I thought we could have an adult conversation, but apparently we can't.
Aaron, if you don't believe in this stuff anymore, then why were you looking for the book?
A man came to see me at my work. Say his building was haunted.
What building?
The Aldridge Mansion. It's obviously a joke. What are you doing?
This is exactly...
Can I find some ghosts?
Yes.
Died 15 years ago.
That's awesome! Dead for 15 years! as a ghost.
I just saw him. So who is this?
Well, that's Ed's son, Ed Jr.
That's obviously him.
Hi, Jr. If I may, when is the last time you hear a normal Ed kid actually seen? And if you were to rank it, let's say between him probably a T1 and T5.
Garrett here saw it on Tuesday, and I believe it made him soil himself. Jesus.
Wow, soiling. I put that in a T3.
T4 if it was food. Unless he ate something weird. Then it wasn't a ghost. Kind of hard to suss that out after the fact, though.
I didn't soil myself. He did. He called me sobbing, saying, oh, my God, my pants are toast.
Do you happen to keep a sample of the soiling?
A sample?
Okay.
I'd love to get that back right away.
I have made the introduction.
Yeah, thank you.
There you go. All right, well, how about you take us across the street? I got to get in there set up. Let's go on a tour.
You're going to die in there.
Aldridge Mansion, take one.
And we are rolling. Checking the settings. We look good.
What is that? Looks like one of those things that makes cotton candy.
It's a PKE meter. There's a ghost anywhere around here. This baby's gonna find it.
It works?
Yeah, it works. I just haven't had the appropriate proximity to an entity for it to work.
Strange reading here. Ma'am, can you tell the story about the world's tiniest bojack?
Came with the shirt.
Okay, somebody really doesn't want us getting in that door. Can you tell us what it's like to walk around in those shoes all day?
It's not fun.
A joke to you guys?
Just your mama.
No, actually, I think the world of your mom. You guys put all that gooey stuff on the floor. You open the basement door. You try to freak me out.
Did not open the basement door.
Basement door's open.
I didn't open it. Did you open it?
I did not open it.
You know what? It was probably Ed and the guy who didn't poop his pants.
I'm over there.
I didn't even know I did that.
Mine's spot too.
Then definitely APX shift.
Yes, for sure. That's
guys.
I think we're alone.
Holy crap.
I have to get around to take you.
Okay.
How can you be eating right now? Won't you pop?
Doctor, part of the physics at Columbia.
Site entitled Ghost News. Not a common case you might have heard of.
I hope you understand that when we give someone tenure...
Oh, I accept your tenure.
When we give someone tenure, they represent this institution. But this is just not what this institution is about.
Dr. Gibbons? Found mold in my office. I gotta move. Don't tell anyone. I don't want people to panic or anything. Kids? Hello? I didn't get fired, even though I have the old plant. Margaret, hi. I'm just taking my plant out for some air. Just have to carry it in this box with all my other personal stuff. Phil, hi. If you turn around, you'll see me. I'm right behind you. Oh, yeah. Just looking at that chart. I couldn't figure that out either. Call me when you figure that out. I haven't been able to. Samantha, hi. How are you? Oh, 16. Sometimes I like to put all my stuff from my office in a box.
The Suzuki Swift Attitude. Now with 0% APR and no deposit. So Suzuki Swift now.
Most important part of your teeth is the enamel, the white, hard, shining armor of protection all around your teeth. When that wears away, slightly yellower starts to show through, and that becomes a little bit darker. I recommend Ponamel because it strengthens the enamel you have and it helps to protect the enamel.
I'm all over the shop, Kev. Can't always be on top of my game.
Who says you can? You're on EE, right?
Of course.
So you've been on the new case best network 5 years running. Most reliable network too.
Unstoppable.
Don't forget, unbeatable 4G coverage!
Right
there! Nice shot. You're on the winning team.
Best of five?
I should never mention that. UK's best net 5 years run. Who says you can? At Ben & Jerry's, everything starts with, what if? Take Mooforia. What if fair trade chunks and swirls were packed into a light ice cream? Would that be ice cream Euphoria? Close. Mooforia. Ben and Jerry's. Just imagine.
No, we have to talk about it openly.
Prefer to keep it private.
This isn't such a subject.
We have had a few issues.
It isn't easy talking about family, but it is important. The M word from Lloyd's Bank. It's good to talk about money.
Dr. Bettman, I think I've got bacteria build-up.
Dr. Bettman, service it deeply. Don't just clean it, service it.
This is my new bedroom from Oak Furniture Land. I've gone for a sort of painted shades of grey kind of look. I just know it's 100% solid hardwood. Now, guess how much I paid for it.
Get all this bedroom furniture with no deposit for less than £36 per month.
It's a steal. Well, not a steal. That would be wrong.
With 4 years to pay at 9.9% APR representative, you can order now at Oak Furniture Land. Together in our beautifully simple chiller. Simple to shop, simple to cook.
You're after. Maybe I can help you. Here's the time. Help all sorts of home buyers. Even scarecrows.
Oh, joy!
What's that, Toto? Can I help Doran?
Oh, will you? Can't you?
Well, I can't give you a mortgage. You're far too young. But I can get you home.
Oh!
Just in the shooting.
There's no place like home. There's no place like home.
From their very first day, your baby starts to write their future. And breastfeeding provides them with the best of their life. Inspired by 40 years of breast milk research, our experts created new Aptamil follow-on milk with ProNutra Advance. If you choose to move on, Aptamil follow-on milk contains our unique blend of ingredients, helping you to lay the foundation for your baby's future. Aptamil follow-on milk, raised and ready. Keep it. Well,
Unlike anyone else, with Sky Mobile, you can roll and keep all your unused data for up to 3 years. So you can dip in and top up your data when you really need it. Or even use it to save money. Roll it, keep it, use it. Sky Mobile. Hello, possible. Introducing the 120th anniversary special edition.
Sky Cinema Action, sponsored by Casiera del Piazza, wine from the devil's cellar.
The following film 15. This film contains strong language and violence.
That night is like some kind of dream. A very blurry, very nightmarish. And I have trouble piecing it together. And it's going to take you a while to work on that.
He's America's most notorious serial killer.
No!
Handsome and charming. He wins the trust of his victims.
Yeah, do you mind helping me with my books here?
Some of the most diabolical people that are out there look like some of the nicest people that you'll ever meet.
You need a help?
Yeah, if you don't mind, it'll just take a minute.
Sure, yeah.
Then takes their lives all to indulge in his depraved obsessions.
Apparently, Ted Bundy likes to have sex with dead girls. Perhaps because they can't say no. Perhaps because it's an issue of control.
He's been captured and escaped twice. And now investigators hope they have the evidence to end his rampage forever.
He really was the ultimate manipulator. He manipulated every person, I believe, that he came into contact with one way or another. Every interaction that he had, I believe, was manipulated for his gain in some way.
The inspiration for characters like Buffalo Bill in The Silence of the Lambs.
It is terrible to say even his say, but he took a honey knife and cut her throat while he was having sex with her.
He's Ted Bundy, serial monster. '78. A serial killer has been spreading terror across the nation. Over 20 women have been abducted and murdered in Washington, Oregon, Utah, Idaho, and Colorado.
He admitted to severing about a half a dozen heads.
A national manhunt has led investigators to Florida, where the killer has unleashed a frenzy of mayhem that's horribly injured 3 women and killed 2 more.
He really was trying to kill as many as he could at one time.
And 30 miles away, he's done the unthinkable. Luring an innocent young girl away from school.
You're really dealing with a kid who couldn't fight back.
Don't even try.
He's left behind few witnesses and little physical evidence. But unbelievably, a routine traffic stop has stopped him in his tracks.
Get out of the car.
Now, while Ted Bundy sits in a Pensacola jail cell, investigators desperately search for Kimberly Leach, the 12-year-old girl they believe he's abducted. They piece together the few clues from a stolen van. The search leads them to the swamplands, Florida's Suwannee River State Park. There, in an abandoned hog shed, they make a gruesome discovery. The mutilated body of Kimberly Leach.
He raped her, but he did not choke her. And it's terrible to say, even to say, but he took a honey knife and cut her throat while he was having sex with her. That was a change in the MO.
Between the Chi Omega attack and Kimberly Leach's brutal and abandoned body, Florida investigators now know the depth of the killer's depravity.
There is something really deeply with Ted Bundy. There's a beast within. It's this creature that has this really demonic appetite, and it's something savage. And for most people, we want to leave those savage tendencies behind. That's what culture and civilization are about. Ted could choose to become a part of society and be civilized and become a lawyer, become wealthy, or he can choose to sort of nurse and engage this dark, dark beast thing within. For some reason, he nurses this dark thing in him that gives him permission to do really extremely violent things.
In July, Ted Bundy is indicted for the kidnapping and murder of Kimberly Leach. And separately, for the Chi
Y Omega murders Lisa Levy and Margaret Bowman to resolve the case quickly and hopefully provide closure for the family members. Prosecutors propose a plea deal.
What involved was Mr. Bundy was completely guilty and has charged all of the charges in the Kyle Mays case, as well as all the charges in the Leach case. Basically, the idea from the prosecution standpoint was that we wanted to make sure that Mr. Bundy was locked up and that he would never be free to do anything like this.
So Bundy plans to again represent himself. He is counseled by celebrated criminal defense attorney Millard Farmer to take the deal. Farmer even flies in Bundy's girlfriend Carol Boone and his mother to encourage him.
As a good, loving, fine young man.
Are you confident that he will be acquitted?
I hope he will be. I can't say I'm confident.
But in May, at the pretrial hearing, the court is packed. Investigators and family members gather to hear what they hope will be Ted Bundy's confession of guilt. But instead, Bundy does just the opposite. He dramatically insults his advising attorneys and tears up the agreement.
At the beginning of the proceeding, Mr. Bundy stood up and he started making a speech. He started criticizing everybody that was involved in the investigation and in the case, and the prosecutor in the Kimberly Leach case looked at each other, and we both stood up and said, "Appeal's off the table."
Ted Bundy could not help himself. He just really wanted to play lawyer. So he circumvented his other lawyers. We think he knows best. I think he thought that the jury would find him so compelling that they would just recognize that he was not guilty just because he was so charming with Mr. Ted Bundy.
Afterward, his legal team is demoralized. Bundy seems more interested in grandstanding than saving his own life.
That plays into the psychopathology of this media grandiosity of presenting this stage to the world that I'm wonderful and I'm great and I'm good at everything. I'm better than everybody else. I believe Ted Bundy thought he was smarter than everybody in the world, and that includes the top lawyers that may have been available to represent him. He felt that he was the best man for the job. In fact, he said on more than one occasion that he was the only attorney that was capable of representing him.
Ted Bundy now faces two separate murder trials, the deaths of young Kimberly Leach and the women of Chi Omega Sorority House. In June, the Chi Omega murder trial begins in Miami, Florida. The trial is a sensation, 250 reporters from across the world requesting access. It's also the first nationally televised trial in U.S. history.
Comes to one case, in the Attorney General's office, and we're putting more resources into this case than we have any other criminal case, as far as I know, in the history of the state of Florida.
I'll plead not guilty right now.
It was just a media frenzy. I mean, there were people from the media from just about every publication you can imagine in the United States of America, as well as foreign correspondents that were there. Television cameras were there, still cameras were also in the
And the star of this television event is Ted Bundy. He'll be advised by attorneys, but will represent himself and be the lead actor on the stage.
It appears that the trial of him representing himself was really another stage for him. It was a way for him to put himself on show and to be the star of that show. He craved the attention that he was getting. He enjoyed being this media sensation, if you will.
He seemed to play to the cameras a lot, absolutely. I think there's no question about that.
The prosecutors have power, but not damning evidence. There's testimony from survivor Cheryl Thomas, who arrived limping from her injury. Cheryl suffered 5 skull fractures, a broken jaw, and permanent hearing loss, dashing her dreams of a dance career. Shocking graphic photos stunned the jury, bringing some to tears.
when Cheryl Thomas walked into the courtroom, everybody's jaw dropped because she was a beautiful young woman. She was going to be a dancer, limping to the stand, losing her balance because her hearing and her inner ear had been destroyed by the attack. And although she couldn't identify Ted, her body language and her body itself was her body.
Then Kyle Naga's sister, Nina Neary, takes the stand. She describes the shadowy figure leading the sorority. But Bundy and his team counter that Nina Neary's testimony is inconsistent and unreliable.
She saw Ted Bundy just in the briefest moment. He ran by her carrying something that looked like a club. It was dark, and he was running so fast she barely saw him. She only saw him in profile. But her testimony was considered weak because it was just so fleeting.
And all along, Ted Bundy behaves like the star of the show. He cross-examines witnesses with all the flourish of a television lawyer. But his performance backfires.
He's very good at arguing little technical points, getting little victories here and there. He thinks he's winning the jury's heads over, but he's losing their hearts. They don't see him care whatsoever about the actual crime he's been accused of. He's playing Perry Mason, and he's reveling in it, and he's enjoying it, and he's very arrogant, and he's losing the jury. He has no idea how bad he made himself look, even though he's got to play a lawyer, which was probably a fantasy for him.
And in the end, the case boils down to some surprising forensics. The savage bite marks left on Lisa Levy's body.
Well, prior to this case, bite mark evidence had never been introduced to the courts of the state of Florida, never been approved for introduction. So one of the things that we had to do is to establish that it was proper scientific evidence.
Lisa Levy was bitten twice. Forensic odontologists say the killer has distinctive bumps on his lower incisors. Bumps match the cast of Ted Bundy's teeth.
The bite mark itself is what is referred to as a double bite. In other words, it's a situation where the person that bit, they bit once, they backed off, and then they bit a second time. So there's actually two bite marks. Right there in that same general area, and using that bite mark as well as a model of Mr. Bundy's teeth that was taken pursuant to court order. The forensic odontologist in the case were able to make a positive identification of Mr. Bundy as the one that left that bite mark that night.
After 3 weeks of testimony, the jury retired. Bundy's surprisingly optimistic. He believes there's one juror, a truck driver, who's sympathetic. He could make it a hung jury. Also, there's laughter heard from the jury room. Could it mean an acquittal?
If I was acquitted, 4 years, what would I have left? I asked myself, could you go to law school? Could you, look? Friends be able to look at me like to be Ted Bundy again. And I figured, whether you're free tomorrow or whether you're free 4 years from now, you're still going to have to make entirely new life, really hide from your old life, whether it was legitimately or illegitimately.
Yeah.
So, that was those are the priorities then.
For the jury, the crime scene images have been damaging. But the case hinges on forensic dental impressions. Two bite marks on the victim's backside.
Ted Bundy was extremely careful not to leave behind any evidence, and he had no idea that bite marks are almost just as damning as fingerprints. These bite marks were not small, little bites. They were savage. It was almost like he was trying to bite and rip apart the flesh. These were like a rabid dog. So the teeth marks are not only a sign of what an animal has done to